Is this how you're supposed to use a lime? Oh my god, why do people do this? Holy sh!
Hey, welcome back to Mixology Flaired. There are countless garnishes you can put on your drinks. From the wedge, to the wheel, the peel, the flame, the twist. Some are for show, and some actually have a purpose. Just don't come to the bar and squeeze a lime in your eye, because we're only just gonna make fun of you and start betting each other what time you're gonna either throw up or get into a fight. Now, the most popular garnish for cocktails is the citrus garnish. So we're gonna talk about lemon wheels, lime wheels, wedges, peels, flame cocktails, and everything in between. Once you've made a delicious cocktail, you can choose the garnish decoration that you're gonna put on top of it. So let's talk about some citrus garnishes. The two most common garnishes that you're gonna see is a wedge and a wheel. Wheels are mainly for decoration. Don't try to squeeze it because nothing's gonna come out. The wedge, not only is it designed to sit on the side of the glass, but it actually has a purpose to squeeze just a little extra juice into the drink if the guest or your friends actually want a little more citrus in their drink. A margarita would typically have a lime wedge to accompany the cocktail. But if you have a daiquiri, there's already an ounce of lime juice in there. So a wheel is only for decoration. If you're making a cocktail like a Negroni, a half wheel like this with an orange is perfect for a decoration right on the side. If you have an old fashioned or you're creating a cosmopolitan, you're gonna wanna cut a peel off an orange or a coin for flaming of the cosmopolitan garnish. Take a really sharp knife and just cut a big peel right down the side, not too deep. You want a little bit of the pith on the inside for structure. So when you go to express the oils over the cocktail that are on the outside of the skin, it has good structure and you can push it right onto the top of the cocktail. For a citrus coin, you want the size of a silver dollar. And when you grab your lighter, you want to warm up the oils on the outside of the skin and then push the oils, because citrus oils are flammable, right into the flame over the top of the cocktail. Another great way to get a really strong peel from an orange is to take a Y peeler. And if you're not familiar with this tool, make sure to go check out our bar tools video that we just posted. You can get a really thick peel like this to rest on top of your cocktails like old fashions. To dress up this garnish, just take your paring knife and slice the sides right off and clean them up a little bit. After that, you'll have a fantastic modern style garnish. A grapefruit peel garnish is fantastic for cocktails like Palomas or any other drink that has any grapefruit juice in it. This is fantastic, slide right inside the glass. It also makes for a very beautiful half wheel that'll sit right inside of your drink. If you make it nice and big like this, it's very decorative, but if that's a little bit too much for you to manage, just cut it in half, put a slice down the side, and it'll sit right on the side of your glass. There's two ways to make a lemon twist. You can get a channel peeler like this one, run it along the outside of the lemon all the way around, follow the tracks where you just were, and you'll be able to pull a really long, beautiful spiral garnish for your drinks. If you don't have a channel peeler like this one, take your knife, cut the ends off of your lemon, a spoon, separate the fruit from the pith on the inside. Once you're finished, squeeze the fruit away from the peel and you'll have an empty shell. Cut one slice down the peel. Now you have one giant peel. Take this peel and roll it up. You can roll it around your bar spoon. Take a garnish pick and pierce the garnish all the way through to hold it together, like this. Now take your knife and very thinly cut yourself some peels. With an average lemon, you're gonna get 6 to 8 really good twists. When you're all finished, you're gonna have a nice peel like this. Wrap it around a bar spoon or your finger. Over the top of your cocktail, you're gonna have a nice twist. Make sure you twist it over the drink. Now remember, garnishes are mostly just decorations for your cocktail. Some of them have a good use case, but most of them are just to make your cocktails look pretty, and there's no right or wrong way to really do it. These are just some of our suggestions, how we decorate our cocktails. We're gonna be giving away this Flair Bar Tool set to one of our subscribers, so make sure you like, subscribe, and comment down below. In the next video, we're gonna choose a winner. Thanks for hanging out with us today. Enjoy your cocktails, and you guys, just remember, good drinks take time. Enjoy the show. Cheers.